Thank you very much, gentlemen, for your opening remarks. And over to you, Shaka Sali, for our first questions to you as we debate tonight.
Thank you very much. Let me go to Ambassador Mutsvangwa again. Ambassador Mutsvangwa, your party, Zanu PF, the last time I checked, it has been in power for 38 years. Could you please tell us what you think is the single most important decision that has been made during the last 38 years? And two, the single most regrettable decision during that period?
The single most important decision we made, I think, was soon after independence, when we said everybody should go to school. The IMF and the World Bank looked at our budget at that time in 1980, and they concluded that we didn't have enough resources to send everybody to school. But being the part which organized the people for a massive military engagement unseen in Africa by any African country against a modern army, we then advised the government to use the little budget which they had to pay teachers. So, and we went to organize the parents in the various villages all over the countryside to build schools for free. There was a competition between the government supplying software, which was the teachers, because that's what we told the government to do, to pay the teachers with that little budget. And we and the parents supplying the hardware. The parents won. Each time there were more schools being built than teachers could be supplied by the central government. We then moved on to address that issue by going back to our guerrilla training camps in Cuba and converted them to teacher training schools. 6,000 teachers were trained in Cuba so that the government could catch up with the frenetic pace which the people of Zimbabwe were building schools. Today, we have the most educated country in Africa. UNESCO standards say so, even ahead of countries which went earlier into independence. A very literate, capable population, which when it goes to foreign countries, it earns hard currency, just like anybody who is in those foreign countries. This is a singular achievement, which is based on the history of organization by ZANU-PF. No African country could aspire to do that the way we did it. So sending people, making them be active citizens in a modern globalized society is what we achieved most. The worst decision was the persistence in having a geriatric becoming president until he felt that he could turn this country into a Mugabezia, like Rhodes had done. Rhodes had turned this country into a Rhodesia. Mugabe wanted to turn it into a Mugabezia. And obviously, we, the war veterans and others, we had to challenge that. And we delivered the change which the other parties had aspired to and failed over a period of time. So
thank you, Ambassador. Thank you, Mr. Ambassador.
Thank you. Just a